Hello folks, and welcome back to my channel. As it says in the description, this is going to be a review and an overview of a brand new chassis system that I ordered. It's the Oryx Chassis, O-R-Y-X, made by MDT, Modular Driven Technologies, who's more famous for chassis systems amongst PRS and long distance shooters. This is kind of their entry level, their budget level. It's about $400 just for the chassis system. I ordered it because the Savage Model 10 that I had, I was having problems with the Accu-stock and I was having problems with the magazine, so I just decided to go with the chassis system. This is my first, this is my entry level. As you know, this is probably not what hunters are used to, but no matter what, it just flat looks cool, and if it shoots well, I'll be very, very happy. So let's go over the chassis itself. It is all aluminum from front to back. It has a very nice grip. It has thumb rest on either side. It has a mag release that's in front of the trigger guard here. It comes with several types of panels. This one happens to be in flat dark earth, but you can get it in OD green or just black. It has a comb adjustment that goes clear up 1 inch as far as scope alignment is concerned, and cheek weld. There's two Allen screws. You raise it up, get to the position you like, and you lock it in. You can order a modular spacers to extend your length of pull. They were currently on back order, so I'll just use my Packmare add-on pad for right now. It uses standard AICS magazines. This one happens to be metal. They were out of the polymer version, so this was 70 bucks by itself. But hopefully this will take care of the magazine issues that I had with the standard Savage magazine. I'll take it out here in just a few minutes, go shoot some rounds through it to see how it shoots. It certainly feels good as far as the weight is concerned. It took the heavy barrel of my Savage Model 10 and kind of balanced it out. The weight of the chassis itself is about 4.5 pounds. Again, you can go to oryx.com and get more information on this chassis, more than I'm capable of giving you. Hopefully it improves my shooting, and we'll find out. So the next part of this video will be actual shooting. I'll see you at the range. Thanks for watching. Okay folks, here's the shots with the Oryx chassis. I've already shot 8 rounds. I forgot that this rifle was sighted in for a 275 yard zero, so at 100 yards it's hitting about 2 inches high. So I went ahead and adjusted the scope down a little bit, but we'll see where it hits now. I'm going to shoot 5 shots so that you can see it. A little bit more about this Oryx chassis. It's got a barricade stop on the front. Some people like to be able to lock it in on whether it's PRS or whatever course that they're working, or just holding it. The grip is interchangeable. Some people like a more vertical grip, and you can get that from Oryx and swap it out. It also has M-lock slots on the bottom for a bipod or for a sling or for an ARCA rail. It also has a quick detach QD on the back here, so you can attach a sling. But so far so good on those 8 shots. So here we go with the last 5. For those of you that say I don't shoot enough and I should be shooting a 5-shot group. So here we go. Don't know why. High. Thank you. Okay, let's go take a look at that group. Well, here's the target, folks. Here's my first 8 shots right here. Considering I was sighted in for 200 yards, it's not bad. Here's the last 5 shots that you saw. That's about a half inch group. I'll take that at 100 yards any cotton picking day. Obviously, I need to adjust the scope, but that's a small issue. If you like this content, folks, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe, leave a comment if you will. Hit the bell notification there for my future videos. But no matter what, thanks for watching. God bless you all. Goodbye.